With CHFI version 8, we're going to learn the forensic methodology. We're going to talk about a lot of the legal issues that underlie doing our seizures and actually being able to catch our bad guys, whether they be internal offenders or offenders outside our organizations. So first thing, we'll talk a little bit about computer forensics. What is forensics or computer forensics? Well, it's based on the concept of forensic science, right? And forensic science, if you look at the definition of it, it says it's the application of physical science to law in search for the truth in civil, criminal, and social behavior matters to the end that injustice shall not be done to any member of society. So, right, what are we trying to do, right? We're trying to determine what has actually occurred by looking at the forensic evidence or the evidence at the scene, and then using some scientific process to help glean what that information means to us. The aim of that is to determine the evidential value of the crime scene and its related evidence. How does this evidence relate back to the crime that was committed? How can we use that to tie it to an individual, maybe either responsible or not responsible? And that's a concept where we talk about inculpatory evidence or exculpatory evidence. Does the evidence tend to show that something did or didn't occur? That would be inculpatory. Or is it exculpatory? Is it evidence that would tend to show that something didn't occur, or maybe that somebody may or may not be responsible for it? We're looking for both kinds of evidence, or we're going to report on both kinds of evidence if we find it. Next slide. Computer forensics. There are a lot of different definitions of what computer forensics is. They all basically include the same sort of material or same sort of verbiage in the definition. When you look at slide 8, we have computer forensics, and we have three different definitions there. The first one is by Dr. H.B. Wolf. It indicates that computer forensics is a methodological series of techniques and procedures for gathering evidence from computer equipment and various storage devices and digital media that can be presented in a court of law in a coherent and meaningful format. The next one is kind of your CS definition. It says preservation, identification, extraction, and interpretation and documentation of computer evidence to include the rules of evidence, legal processes, integrity of the evidence, factual reporting of the information found, and providing expert opinions in a court of law or other legal or administrative proceeding as to what was found. And the last one, the third one, is kind of a short, down and dirty definition of what computer forensics is. And that is, forensic computing is the science of capturing, processing, and investigating data from computers using a methodology whereby any evidence discovered is acceptable in a court of law. And that is kind of the down and dirty of what computer forensics is. What are we trying to do? Well, we want to take digital evidence, whether that digital evidence is a computer or a cell phone or a camera, an iPod, whatever kind of digital device that we're talking about, we want to get the evidence out of that. But we need to do that evidence, we need to collect that evidence in a manner that is going to allow us to get that into a court of law. And when we talk about the CHFI in general, that's one of the things you're going to see that we really emphasize in the CHFI. We're talking about computer forensics, not just about getting data off of the machine. A lot of times anybody that has some technical training may be able to go in there and find the data, but if we collect that data in a manner that we can't get that information into a court of law or into an administrative proceeding, what have we done? We've really kind of wasted our time, because now we have a bunch of information that might be very important to us, and yeah, we might be able to prove something to, you know, the general public, but if we can't get it into an administrative proceeding or a legal proceeding of some sort, we may have just wasted a whole bunch of our time.